MKidz, welcome. Are you just loving spending time together online? Sure, we miss seeing each other, but at least we get to have some fun here too. Anyway, it's almost Lent, and we are very excited to start with this series where we discover so many wonderful things. But before we get there, are you ready for today? So let's get started.
I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got love for my Savior, I've got love for my Savior, I've got love for my Savior in my soul. I've got love for my Savior, I've got love for my Savior, I've got love for my Savior in my soul. I've got joy like
Look at that little boy.
He has so many bananas. Wow, they look amazing.
All the bananas in the woods are finished. I think Zip took them all for Gray. I really want a banana.
Aw, you're such a cute little monkey. Oh, coochie coochie coo.
Hey, don't tickle me. I'm not a teddy bear. What do you want there here in the woods? Don't you know I am a wild animal?
Wild animal? But you're so cute.
Cute? I'm Ola, the wild animal of the Mosaiek Woods.
Oh no, you're a little cutie pie in Mosaiek Woods. Why are you so grumpy?
Wouldn't you also be if you hadn't eaten since this morning? All the bananas are finished.
Oh, poor monkey. I have a banana for you. Ola, it is so easy for me to get bananas, and I want to look after you. Let me arrange with you. I will look after you and give you what you need. If you want to, you can be my monkey and still be free here in your woods.
What? You mean you will always bring me bananas?
Even better than that, I promise I will look after you and be there when you need me. We can be best friends.
What's the catch? Well, what should I do?
There isn't one. You can come and meet me.
Friends? Is this too good to be true? This sounds amazing. This promise can be wonderful. But wait a bit. Maybe the MKidz auntie can say a bit more about this. I think she mentioned that today is all about a promise or arrangement. Maybe she can help me to understand. Go get yourself a banana as while you listen to today's scripture.
Friends, so today I'm going to read you a passage from the Bible. We read this in Genesis 17. It's a little bit difficult, but with a little bit of explanation, I am sure that all of you will understand this. So, let's hear it. This is where God speaks to Abram. So, when Abram was 99 years old, very old, the Lord appeared to him. So, when God appears to someone, they can usually see him and he speaks to them so they can hear him and see him. So, God appeared to Abram and he said, I am the God Almighty. serve me faithfully, I will make a covenant with you. So a covenant is an agreement between God and us, and it's usually a promise that God makes, and it's also a good thing for us. I will make a covenant with you by which I will guarantee to give you countless descendants. Descendants is where Abram has a child, and his child has children, and they have children, and their children have children, and so it goes on. And Abram will eventually have all of these descendants. An entire nation will be his. So at this, Abram fell with his face down on the ground, and then God said to him, "This is my covenant with you. I will make you the father of many nations. What's more, I am changing your name. It will no longer be Abram. Instead, you will be called Abraham with an H in the middle. For you will be the father of many nations. I will make you extremely fruitful. Your descendants will become many nations, and there will be kings among them." So some of his descendants will be kings. How great is that? "And I will confirm my covenant with you and your descendants after you from generation to generation." So the generation are those descendants. "This is the everlasting covenant. It will be forever and ever. I will always be your God and the God."
Willa, I'm so glad you called me. That is actually precisely what I want to talk to you about today. I want to explain two words. Friends, will you quickly go and get a piece of paper and a pencil? Once you have them, you can play the video again. Okay, are you ready? Fold your paper in half. On one side, you can now write the word agreement. If you can't write yet, please ask a parent or someone around you to help you. Now, on the other half of the paper, please write the word promise. Draw a picture of two people shaking hands below the word agreement. They're making a deal. They decide on something together and then stick to it. Under the word promise, draw a picture of God smiling. God went to Abram and made an agreement with him. This agreement was even better than the agreement Zach made with Ula. The absolute wow thing is that God does much more than his part with this agreement. God says he will be with Abram. God and will be with him and bless him, including him and his children, and his children, and their children, etc. God decides on something that he will abide by. What is Abram's part in all of this? What's his part of the deal? He must live close to God and enjoy the wonderful agreement. It's not something he has to earn, it's a gift. Take another look at your other picture and the word promise. God promises that he will never forget his agreement. Another word for this agreement is covenant. So Ola, you asked if what Zach promised is too good to be true. I'm sure Zach means well and you can enjoy the agreement he makes with you. But no human is trustworthy as God is. People can sometimes break their promises and not keep what they say, but God will never break his promise. He will surely always be your God. You can put all your trust in God. God invites you to enjoy this agreement that he makes with you, to be your God and to always be with you. You can hold on to his promise. He is with you. He blesses you.
Hello, friends. Close your eyes and then we can pray together. Thank you, Jesus, that we can know that you are always with us. Thank you that we don't have to be scared of anything because you will always take care of us. Please bless every little child listening to this today. Amen.